Hi everyone, my name is Kevin. Today I want to show you how you can take a screenshot on your PC using Windows 10. And full disclosure, before we jump into this, I work at Microsoft. Okay, let's jump into it. Here I am on my desktop and we need something to take a screenshot of. I don't know, I can't think of anything better than my YouTube page. So here's my YouTube page and it has a picture of me in an awkward pose with my finger pointing up. We're gonna take a screenshot of this today. I'm gonna show two different methods to take a screenshot. One uses an app that comes with Windows 10, and the second technique is using your keyboard. So let's start out with the app that comes with Windows 10. Probably the easiest way you could get to it is to open up search and then to type in Snipping Tool. That's the name of the app, the Snipping Tool. So I'm gonna go ahead and type it in, and there you see it right there. The other way you could get to it is I could click on the start menu, and this is the long way to get to it. I'll go into the start menu, scroll to the very bottom down here, and then there's a section called Windows Accessories. What's interesting is this shows you all the other things that also come with Windows. You got a fancy note-taking program called Notepad, very basic. You also have a souped-up one called WordPad, and not quite at the level of Word. And then here we also see the Snipping Tool. If you want easier access in the future, you can pin that to the start menu, which shows up where all these apps are over here. I could also click on more and I could pin it to the taskbar. I've already pinned it to the taskbar, which is why it says unpin. So I pinned it to the taskbar because this is a tool and an app that I use quite often. So what I'm gonna do is I'm gonna click on it on the taskbar to open up the Snipping Tool. Now there are a few different modes that the Snipping Tool has. You could do a full screen capture. With a full screen capture, that simply takes a screenshot of the entire desktop. There's also a window snip, and I'll show you how that works. So here I could select a window if I wanna take a screenshot of my browser, or I could take a screenshot of the whole desktop. There's also rectangular snip and freeform snip. So with a rectangular snip, I could simply highlight an area of the page that I want to take a screenshot of. And the other mode, the freeform, I can try my best to select an area that I want to take a screenshot of. And here I'm going to do my best at creating a rectangle. And there you have it. There's my screenshot of myself. What I could do then is I could go to File, Save As, and I could save this as different file types. I have the option of doing a PNG, a PNG, I guess. I also have a GIF or a GIF, depending on who you talk to. And then there's also a JPEG. So I could choose what type of file. A PNG is the default that I could save it as. I could also email to someone, make a copy. Here I could save again as well. What I can also do with this tool, you can annotate. So here there's a pen tool. Let's say that I want to give myself a little mustache, and then I want to give myself a nice fake tan. There I could highlight myself in yellow. And there you could annotate. If you take a screenshot of text and you want to highlight it, you could do all that. I could also go ahead and erase that because I don't know if I like my fake mustache and the fake tan. What you could also do, which is kind of neat, is you could set a delay. So similar to when you're taking a photo of your family and someone wants to hit the take photo button and you all run together and smile, you could set your delay. Of course, someone's eyes will probably be shut and you'll have to take your photo again. But there's one way you could delay take a photo. So this is the Snipping Tool, pretty useful tool if you want to take a screenshot. Okay, so now that we've looked at the Snipping Tool, what I want to do next is I want to show you how you could take a screenshot using your keyboard. So I have a few different keyboards because depending on the type of keyboard you have, the way you print your screen is going to be a little different. First, we're going to look at my Dell keyboard. On my Dell keyboard, there is simply a section that says Print Screen. And so what I'm going to do is, because it's in blue, I need to press the function key at the same time. So I'll simply press function and print screen at the same time. And then there the screenshot was saved. If I click here, it looks like it automatically saved it to OneDrive. Here's the print screen that I just did. This is a Microsoft keyboard. There's simply a button that says PRTSCN. That's the abbreviation for print screen. I'm printing the screen out. That's where that comes from because I want to print a copy of this. All I do is I simply press the print screen button, and then that also takes a screenshot. And then I also have my Lenovo laptop here, and there's a key here that says PRTSC. That also allows me to print the screen. Now, a few of the fancy things that you could do. So print screen simply takes a screen capture of the entire screen. What I could also do is, let's say I select this window and I just want to take a screenshot of this window. What I could do is just press the Alt key and print screen at the same time. And so if I go into here, you'll see that that took a screenshot of just that window. So even if my desktop is bigger than that window, I can limit the screenshot just to that window. Another kind of neat technique is if you press the Windows key and print screen at the same time, it'll simply automatically save that. So there it saved a copy. And where it puts that is it puts it in pictures. So you go to this PC, Pictures and Screenshots, and there you see that it just saved the screenshot. Although if you have your computer connected to OneDrive and you simply hit print screen, it already saves it to OneDrive, so it kind of does the same thing. Today I showed you two different ways you could take a screenshot. One of them is with the snipping tool. The other way is using your keyboard and hitting the print screen button, and a few combinations of that depending on what you want to do. Hopefully that unblocks you with all your screenshot needs. If you enjoyed this video, please give it a thumbs up. I love seeing thumbs up. And if you want to see future tech videos like this, hit that subscribe button, and that way you'll get a notification anytime new content like this comes out. All right, well, thanks for watching, and I'll see you next time.